Hey everyone, my name is Anthony and I work on a brand new service at Microsoft called Azure Static Web Apps. And today we're going to look at how we can build and deploy a Hugo website along with a Python serverless API. Azure Static Web Apps provides a way to host your static site. This could be a single page application that's built with something like React or Vue or Angular, or something built with a static site generator like Hugo or Gatsby. We also allow you to add any backend logic that you might need using serverless APIs. And these APIs can be built with Python, as well as JavaScript or C#. And then you take both your web app and your API and put them in the same GitHub repository. And then we take care of building and deploying them to the cloud using GitHub Actions. And the static assets are globally distributed, so your site is going to be super fast from anywhere in the world. And the serverless APIs scale dynamically, so they'll perform great no matter how busy your site is. And let's take a look at a few other features of Azure Static Web Apps. I already talked about the globally distributed hosting of your static assets, as well as the serverless APIs and the GitHub Actions integration that's going to go and build and deploy your application every time you make a commit to your repository. And as with really any site that you want to build, you probably want to bring along a custom domain. You can do that with Azure Static Web Apps, and we give you a free SSL certificate when you do that. And Azure Static Web Apps has a really good local development story. There's a VS Code extension that allows you to deploy your app to the cloud. And there's also a local CLI that allows you to run both your front-end application along with your backend APIs, if you have any, together on your local machine. And you can test out things like routing as well as authentication, all without deploying your app to the cloud. And there's also support for staging environments. So every time you make a pull request against your repository, we'll actually stand up a staging environment for you so that you can preview your site before merging your code to your production branch. And there's also things like built-in authentication and custom routes. So if you want to integrate with authentication providers like GitHub or Twitter and things like that, you don't have to write any code. We handle that all for you. And there's also a bunch of enterprise features in Azure Static Web Apps as well. All right, so enough slides. Let's look at some code. So what I have here is a very basic Hugo application. And I'm gonna use the Azure Static Web Apps VS Code extension to deploy it to Azure. So what it's going to ask me for is whether or not I want to upload it to a new GitHub repository. I'm going to say yes to that, and I'll give it a name, and I can decide whether this is a public or private repository. And then I give my site a name, and out of the box, we know how to build from quite a few different frameworks. I'm going to choose Hugo. And then I need to tell Azure Static Web Apps where my Hugo app lives. It's in the folder called blog, so that's what I'm going to fill in here. And it asked me for a location for an API. I don't have an API in my project right now, but I want to add one later. So I'm just going to fill in API as the folder. And by default, Hugo outputs the final content to be deployed into a folder called public. And then I'm going to choose a region. As I said, the app is actually globally distributed. But the region decides where the function app lives. And then just like that, I'm done. And then as you can see, the GitHub action has already kicked off. And as we kind of browse around our GitHub repo, you can see that Azure Static Web Apps has added a GitHub workflow on our behalf that contains a very simple GitHub action that's got the settings that we entered earlier. And then going back to our action, we can actually see that it's finishing up right now. And it's done. And then back in VS Code, we can just click on Browse Website, and we can take a look at the app live on Azure. So now back in VS Code, let's take a look at our app. Like I said, it's a super simple Hugo app. I've basically created one page here. And in the page, I actually have a form that's using this kind of like this magical way of render a form onto my page. I don't really have to do anything. The theme provides the form for me. But the form needs to send an email, right? And I need something to send that email. So I'm going to set up a serverless API using Python to do this. And to do this, I'm going to use the Azure Static Web Apps VS Code extension again. This time I'm going to choose create an HTTP function. And I'm going to choose Python. And then I get to choose my version of Python. And then I'm going to call my function contact. And here we go. This is our function. And we can quickly try out this function just by pressing F5. It's going to go and start up the local emulator for us. And then I can click on the URL. And here it is. Here's my function. It's a really simple hello world thing that's provided to us. You can see that I put in my name and it's saying hello back to us. And the next thing that we want to do is to change this function so that it can send an email. So Azure Functions has a concept of input and output bindings. And you can use these bindings to talk to external services without writing any code. So you can see in my function.json, I have a just an HTTP trigger defined, but I can add more bindings here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add an output binding to SendGrid by just right-clicking on the file and saying add binding. And then I'm going to go ahead and choose SendGrid as the output binding, but you can see the other bindings that we have supported here as well. I'm just going to name it message. And then I need to create a new app setting. And this app setting is for saving the SendGrid API key so that we don't actually, you know, just store that as hard-coded in the code and check it into source control. I'll call this setting SendGrid API key. That sounds like a good name. And then I'll go ahead and paste in the value. And then in the email that I send, I also need to provide a to address as well as a from address. I'll give it a subject. Let's call it contact form. And then I'll just leave the message text blank because we're going to fill that out in the function itself. So there you go. You can see that it's added the output binding for us in this function.json. So we don't really have to worry about, you know, like the format of this or how to type this out. All right. So now we're going to just modify our function to use that output binding. We're going to just pass that in as a parameter. We're going to create some message text to send in the body of the email. And to send something, we just have to pass a piece of JSON that represents our message to the output binding. And then lastly, we're going to redirect the user back to our homepage. And then another thing that we have to do is we have to make sure that we modify our form to call our function. And the URL of the function is /API/contact. And that's all we really need to do. So the next thing we want to do now is let's build our site using Hugo. And just by typing the word Hugo, it's built it. And if we look into our public folder, you can see that this is the output of the site. And then as I mentioned earlier, Azure Static Web Apps has a CLI that you can download. You can get it from NPM. I already have it installed and you can just type SWA to use it. So to start up our emulator locally, I'll type SWA start, and then I need to give it the public folder. That's the static assets that we wanted to serve, as well as our API folder. And when we run it, it's going to start up. And the emulator is going to be accessible locally on port 4280. And we'll just go to our browser and go to localhost 4280. And there it is. There's our site. We're going to click on our post. And here's our form. We're going to quickly fill it out. And click send. Looks like it's worked. Let's go and check my email to really confirm that it's actually working. And there it is. There's the email. Awesome. So what we got to do now is deploy this new version of our site with the API to Azure. And the only thing that we have to do is to make a commit to our Git repo and then just push it to GitHub. And then the GitHub action is going to fire and it's going to deploy our site. And we actually have to do one more thing, which is to configure the SendGrid key in Azure as well. So there's a gesture in VS Code to do this, and that's what we'll do right now. And then let's check out the site. So it's already live, and I will just try filling out the form and then pressing send, and then fingers crossed. Looks like it worked. Let's check our email really quick. And there it is, there's our message. And that's how easy it is to deploy a Hugo site along with a Python API using Azure Static Web Apps. Please go and check out the service and let us know what you think. Thank you.